I recently got my hands on this old hatchet and I wanted to give my best effort in bringing this back to life. Now, being that this was my first opportunity to restore something, I was not sure what it was going to look like in the end. Overall, I thought the metal looked pretty good, but there was a lot of craters in it and I was a little concerned on how much material I have to remove to clean it up. I started taking off material using a 60 grit flap disc. Now, majority of this is pretty self-explanatory, so it's just going to be a lot of grinding and switching discs between 60 grit and 80 grit. So I'll jump in if I feel like there's something that needs to be explained. There are a few spots that are pretty deep and I'm trying to reserve it as much as possible, so I'm going to take a Dremel and just kind of touch up on those areas. At this point, I think I've removed enough material and I don't want to go any further, so any craters that's left over, I'm just going to have to work with it. I switched over to an orbital sander and I went through four different grits of sandpaper. I started off with 120 grit first, then I switched over to 220, then 320, and finally 400. The final stage of sanding will be done by hand. I went from 800 grit to 1000 to 1500 and finally 2000. This is a half inch steel rod which I cut down and then epoxy it into the handle. It doesn't serve any real purpose other than to keep the handle from looking so plain. To remove some of the sandpaper scratches, I'm going to take it over to the buffer and give it a quick polish. The reason why I cut the eye of the axe handle is because I want it to sit down on the head, and I'm gonna finish it off with epoxy. After driving in the wedge, I can then come back and cut that down after the glue setup. I'm gonna use a casting resin from countertop epoxy to finish off the eye of the handle. For the color, I went with a charcoal pigment and I just mixed that in. I sprayed a little alcohol and that relieved the bubbles and also gave it a smooth finish.